now a U.S. education story with a twist. Relations between charter schools and traditional public schools have often been hostile, and that has become a more intense problem in recent years. About 4% of U.S. students attend about 5,000 charter schools. Special correspondent for education John Merrow reports on one school district that's swimming against that tide.
It would be difficult to overstate the battle royal going on between traditional public schools and charter schools. Charter schools, which are publicly funded but privately run, were conceived of as testing grounds for traditional schools.
To me, charter schools are public schools that free teachers to do what teachers know best to do.
Charter schools are free to hire uncertified teachers, set their own pay scales, and fire teachers they feel aren't measuring up. From the beginning, many in education saw charter schools as a threat, robbing traditional schools of students and scarce education dollars.
We have seen constant promotion of charter, charter, charter. And what's happening is that in many cities today, we are on the verge of losing public education altogether.
Charter school supporters promised academic success, but the results have been mixed. Take math, for example. According to a 2013 study, 29% of charter schools do better than traditional schools, 31% do worse, and 40% score about the same. Some operators have used their charter schools as a license to steal. Today, the chasm between charter and traditional schools is greater than ever.
Good morning.
But here in Houston, Texas, in the Spring Branch School District, something astounding, even revolutionary, is taking place.
I don't see charter schools as a threat to traditional schools. I see charter schools, particularly high-performing charter schools, as kind of incubators of innovation.
Rather than go to battle, Superintendent Duncan Klusman stuck his neck out and invited two successful charter school networks into two of his schools, both of them facing declining enrollment. The charter school students are selected by a lottery.
Good morning.
Eric Schmidt is the principal of Kip Courage, one of 141 KIPP charter schools nationwide.
Good morning, Daisy.
We've got 200 students in fifth and sixth grade. We'll grow out to have 400 students in 5 through 8. And like all of our schools, we do our work in underserved communities where a majority of the students qualify for free or reduced lunch.
2 years ago, KIPP Courage began sharing space with Landrum Middle School, a traditional public school.
Good morning.
Patricia Thomas is principal of Landrum Middle School.
Our school is a grade 6 through 8 campus. We have about 750 students.
How did Thomas feel about having a newcomer, a competitor, setting up shop in her building?
A little bit leery of the program and what was going to go on. Didn't really know what the program was about, how it was going to work as a partnership.
Knowing that bringing in charter schools would be controversial, Klusman did his best to reassure his teachers.
When I met with the faculties early on, I guaranteed them that no one in Spring Branch would lose their job over this partnership.
The president of the local union, an affiliate of the American Federation of Teachers, objected.
Why is it with the amount of leadership that we have and the amount of innovation that we have within the district, did we call it an outside source?
But teacher unions in Texas have limited power, and so Klusman's experiment continued.
All right, what's another way to write a ratio out of this information?
At Landrum, the union of charter and traditional means that KIPP math teacher Ryan Hambley has access to classroom technology he wouldn't have at KIPP.
Because we're at Landrum, we get provided 4 iPads. We get provided 4 netbooks and beautiful technology such as Promethean boards and pens.
KIPP and Landrum hire their own teachers for core courses like math and reading. It's here in the elective courses, band, orchestra, choir, art, theater, and phys ed, that the charter and traditional schools come together. On its own, KIPP could not afford to offer so many choices.
We are an envy of the town among the KIPP world because we offer so many electives.
KIPP gets the additional courses, and Landrum gets to send its teachers to KIPP's training program.
All of the elective teachers came and participated in our summer professional development that we had at KIPP. And then we also opened it up to other teachers in Landrum, core content teachers. And there was a team that came and said, we want to specifically learn about the character strengths.
Building character is uppermost in KIPP's list of educational goals.
KIPP is defined by the fact that we're 51% character, 49% academics.
KIPP's impact on Landrum seems far greater than the reverse.
Spring Branch had a program called Development Assets, Character Education, and so we kind of morphed ours to be more aligned with KIPP.
In the cafeteria, the Landrum and KIPP students may choose to eat separately, but they all spend the first few moments quietly reading or doing homework.
This was a KIPP practice where they sit down first before they mass runs into the lunchroom and goes to the line.
2 years into the partnership, Landrum and KIPP are still working out the kinks. One problem? Finding time when KIPP teachers who have a longer school day can work together with Landrum teachers.
We're working on aligning our schedules for our seventh grade team of teachers next year. So we'll be adding seventh grade and have that for the first time. And so allowing teachers to have similar off time during the day so that math teachers can get together and collaborate on ideas.
Teacher turnover is also a problem. Yes Prep, the second charter school Klusman invited in, replaced 5 of its 8 teachers after the first year. 2 were promoted, 3 left, according to Yes Prep's principal, because it wasn't the right fit.
A&M, you guys averaged an 83%.
So how's this 2-year-old partnership working out? The leaders seem pleased.
I like to bounce ideas off of Eric, him being the young guy, me the older. You know, he might have a different idea and vice versa.
Teachers are also generally happy with this new arrangement, according to a survey. Academically, however, the results are mixed. Reading and math scores at Landrum are flat. Those at Northbrook have improved slightly. At both schools, the charter students are generally outperforming the traditional students. And that actually benefits the traditional schools because Klusman combines the test scores when he reports them to the state.
When we report scores from the campuses, we report the school overall. For accountability reasons, all the scores are Landrum Middle School, Northbrook Middle School, Spring Branch ISD scores. They just may be in a KIPP or Yes Talk class.
Could partnerships like this one in Spring Branch catch on? Perhaps. So far, 19 school districts, including Milwaukee, Tulsa, and Denver, have come to take a look.